Hey guys, this is Abhishek from gadgetreviews.com, and today we are here at the Xiaomi launch event. So Xiaomi has announced four devices. Out of these four devices, one of them is Mi 3, one of them is Mi Pad, which we have with us. We have some other devices like Redmi 1S and Redmi Note as well. So other three devices apart from Mi 3 will come to Indian market very soon, most probably by August 2014. In the first week of August, you might see the Redmi 1S, and by the end of August, you will see the Redmi Note as well coming to the market. So this is the kind of announcement they have done so far. So in this video, we are going to talk about the Mi Pad, which is a tablet, a quite affordable tablet basically from Xiaomi. So again, it is pronounced at Xiaomi, not Xiaomi. Anyways, let's go ahead and take a look over the Mi Pad. So this is how it looks. It looks, in terms of the look, definitely it looks exactly like an iPad mini. In terms of the display size, it has a 7.9 inch display, and you have an IPS panel. As far as the display is concerned, it is an IPS LCD panel, and you can see that you have pretty good viewing angles as well. So once you take a look at it, you can see the display from almost any angle. Again, we are doing this video in daylight, and you can see that the device display does have some smudges as well, which is again going to happen, but you can clean it always. But the display will get a lot of smudges and fingerprints over time when you start using it. And again, one thing which I really don't like is the glossy back, which will also get a lot of fingerprints and scratches as well over time. However, the build quality of this tablet is pretty good. It is very nicely built. It does not look like a cheap tablet. It is going to be an affordable tablet, but slightly pricey, not that affordable as well, because it comes with the latest NVIDIA Tegra K1 chipset, which is supposed to be the most powerful chipset. And this tablet, as per they say, is specifically designed for the people who would like to do gaming on their Android tablet. So we have Android running on this one, and we have a custom MIUI running on this one as well. As you can see, as far as UI is concerned, which is quite responsive and fluid as well. When it comes to the configuration, it is running on Android OS. We will just tell you the version of Android as well. Apart from this, if we talk about the processor, you have got NVIDIA Tegra K1, which is the chipset. And again, when it comes to the CPU, you have quad-core 2.2 GHz Cortex A15 based processor. And when we talk about the GPU, you have ULP GeForce Kepler 192 cores GPU, which is going to be one of the best GPU you can have in a tablet like this. And this is the first tablet to have this chipset and this kind of GPU configuration. When we talk about other things of the device, we do have a 6700 milliampere hour battery on this tablet, which is again going to give you good amount of power. It is right now approximately 90% of battery, and as per the claims which we have, it should give you around 11 hours of multimedia experience, which is pretty good, I would say. And you can have 86 hours of music playback. So we will confirm all this, we will test all that. Let's take a look over the closer look over the tablet. So this is how the tablet looks like. And once I show you the backside is glossy. You have the micro USB port for data syncing and charging, which is also having a chrome finish, which makes it look premium. And then you have the loudspeaker mesh. You have two loudspeakers on this device, which is definitely a welcome move. You have Mi branding over there. And at the back side, we have the camera. The camera on this device is a 8 megapixel camera at the rear. So this is an 8 megapixel autofocus camera. You do have some additional slot over here for the microphones. So you have one microphone over here, another microphone over here. That means you do have two microphones on this device, especially for noise cancellation, which is good. At the top, you have the 3.5mm audio jack. On this side, you have two buttons, which are again the plastic buttons. They are finished in chrome. They will give you good amount of feedback as well, and you can easily feel them, which is good. And again, the edges are also glossy. So again, the grip of this tablet may not be that great. It is slightly bigger tablet to hold in one hand, but still you can hold it just like an iPad, but it won't give you the metal feel at least. As far as features are concerned, you will get Wi-Fi Direct and Wi-Fi hotspot feature as well on this one. And you should also have a micro USB card slot. So the micro USB card slot will be here. So I think it is not the micro USB card slot, I guess. Let me just confirm this. Okay, this one does not have GPRS or phone connectivity. So this is definitely for the micro SD card. And you can open this and then expand the storage of this device. This device is going to be available in different storage model. You will also get it in 16 GB or 64 GB. There is no 32 GB variant of the Mi Pad. In terms of the build quality, it looks good. The display has pretty good viewing angles. The display also have Corning Gorilla Glass 3 as well. So once you take a look over the display, the display is actually not very weak. It is a kind of a Corning Gorilla Glass, so you will not get to see the scratches at least very easily on the front. I would recommend you to go for a flip cover, which might be coming as a necessary later on. So you will be able to buy this device initially from Flipkart once it gets available. So let's talk about the software of this device. So the software is something which is very exciting because you have MIUI running on this device, which is definitely making the device quite different in terms of the look and feel. It does not look like a cheap Android tablet. It is a very good premium Android tablet, I would say. You do have some additional widgets over there. So again, the UI seems to be inspired from the iOS UI. So this is how it looks like. You have widgets over here for the calendar, for the calculator. You can do quick calculations over here with these widgets. You have a analog widget for the date. You have a widget for the music. You have theme UI widget over there, and then you have all these icons, and this is again looking exactly like iOS. So let's take a look over the settings and show you what all things you get as far as the inbuilt configuration of this tablet is concerned. You do have notification center over here, which is again not like the one which you might have seen on the stock Android tablets. It is a custom notification center, and you do have toggles over there. You can actually adjust the brightness from here. I can go into the settings and I can go to the other toggle screen as well, I guess. So here we have notifications, which we do not have any notifications on this tablet. And let me just go into settings. So once we go into settings, this is how it will look like. Let me just show you the version of Android running on this device. So as of now, the version of Android which is running on this MI Pad is 4.4.2. And I think this is the build one. So the build name basically. You have 2.2 gigahertz processor. You have 2 GB of RAM on this device. And internal memory is 16 GB on this one. And out of which approximately 13.26 GB is available to the user, which is definitely a good thing. Talking about other things for the device, let me just show you the storage over here as well. So here is how the storage has been distributed. There is no bloatware. There is no extra application which will come pre-installed, which might waste the total storage space. You will get around 13.46 GB available on this device out of 16 GB, which is pretty good. You do have an SD card slot, and you can actually mount a USB drive as well. That means this tablet will also have the OTG support as well. You can connect a flash drive with the help of an OTG cable, which might come within the package. We cannot confirm that as of now. Talking about the other things for the device, let's take a look over the RAM scenario. And for this, I will go to Apps Manage. And once I go to Apps Manage, I can show you the running processes. So these are the running processes which are right now there in the background. But taking a look at it, I cannot actually find out how much of RAM is actually free. Let me just go to About Tablet again, and if I can see the current available RAM. So 2 GB of RAM is there, and again I cannot find how much of RAM is actually free because it does not give you the indication of that. Again, the device is responsive, there is no problem. The UI is again very fluid, very flat UI, very nice UI. It is one of the smoothest UI I have seen on any Android tablet running. So definitely positive feedback I have for this one. You do have swipe to type supported as well with the help of the keyboard which you have on this device, which is a good thing. And then you have date and time settings over there. You have additional settings for the headphones. You have options over here to see the battery indication over there at the top. And then we have other things like notification, sound, display. So over here you can control the sound settings. You can customize different kind of sound which you can have on this tablet. So you can do that. When it comes to the display, you have brightness supported, and automatic brightness is supported on this tablet, which is definitely a good thing. And then you have portable Wi-Fi hotspot option as well. So you can actually do the tethering as well on this device, that you can do. And this is something which is definitely a good move. And taking a look over the front, we can say at the bottom, we have the touch capacitive buttons. They do have backlit LEDs, so they will light up whenever you tap on them or touch them. Then you have the camera over there. This is a 5-megapixel camera. We will just confirm whether it is autofocus or fixed focus. It should be a fixed focus camera, I guess. Taking a look over the clock, this is how the clock looked like. And again, all the UI, all the things, including the file explorer, everything is like very seamless, very simple, very flat design. So it is very simple to actually recognize the UI, what you need to do, how you need to do, all this you can do. You can also enable a wireless file manager on this one. You can enable the FTP mode, and in this case, you can actually share the file from this explorer which is coming pre-installed. So these applications are just not any other application which will come pre-installed. These are kind of customized applications which will give you a lot of options, a lot of extra things which you can do on this tablet, which actually makes it quite unique. You have MI credits over there, which is again a kind of a account system for MI users, so that you can get some credit and then you can redeem them later. You have MI cloud server options over there, so that you can sync your data, locate your device and do other things on the tablet. From again, even if you don't have the tablet, if the tablet is stolen, you can locate it with the help of the MI cloud services. You can sign up for that, and then the sign up is again free, and there is some storage also which will come for free. You have Notes application over there, which should also look like the Notes application which I see on an iPad or something like that. So this is how the keyboard will look like. You do have the option of changing it to the QWERTY keyboard. This is how the QWERTY keyboard will look like. And when it comes to swipe to types, by default it is not enabled, but you can make it supported with the help of third-party applications. So the default keyboard does not have swipe to type, but you can do swipe to type. You can also include images as well within the Notes, which is definitely a good thing. Let's take a look over the camera now, and I will take a photo of any object over there. So I have an object over there, and I can take a photo of this one. The camera UI is very simple and easy to use, I would say. And this is another simple and sleek camera UI, which you might have seen on a similar kind of UI, which you might have seen on the iOS devices as well, including iPad mini. And here we have some options over there. You can toggle back to the front camera. This is how the front camera will look like. The front camera is definitely a good camera for video chat. It gives you complete full screen view. You can do a good quality of video chat, you can see that this is how it will show you. So pretty good front camera, I would say. It does have face detection as well, although it does not have focus. So focus is not there, autofocus is not there, but you can always tap to locate or basically find out a face whenever you are doing a video call. You can actually turn on the audio off. You can change the skin of the camera as well. All that you can do. You can actually apply some real-time effects on the camera by selecting any of these, so which is good. And here we have the recording button, and here we have the you can say the camera shutter key. Let me just take a photo of this object, and I will show you this photo later on. So you do have autofocus and tap to focus. And I've just taken this photo, and I will show you this photo and some other photo which I've taken. So the camera which we have at the backside is an 8 megapixel camera over there. It does not have LED flash, but it does give you pretty good photos when you have daylight or good amount of light falling on the subjects. So you can have very good photos on this device once you take it from the rear camera. As you can see, the amount of details as well as the color production is definitely good. But again, we have taken this photo in daylight, so it is already looking good. But we do have some other photos as well on this device which we have taken. Okay, these photos have been taken not by me but some other people, and you can see the low light performance of this device is also pretty good. So the camera performance is definitely better and very good, and you do have the same kind of icons and UI design which you might have seen on an iOS device, including an iPad. So we do have a video player, a browser and all these things. So basic application will become pre-installed, and you can again install any application on this device. When it comes to the overall specifications and the kind of form factor this tablet has, this tablet does not weigh very heavy. It is kind of a light tablet, slightly difficult to hold because it has glossy back, but again it looks like a decent machine. It weighs around 360 gram, which is again comparable to any other tablet which is there in the market, so which is good. The thickness of the tablet is around 8.5 millimeter, which is again making this tablet not too thick. It is comparable to an iPad Air in terms of thickness. The resolution is something which is quite amazing, because you have a 2K display on this device, which is 1536x2048 pixels. So which is definitely a good thing. 7.9 inch of display, which is again pretty big for media consumption on the go, and it is a portable tablet. It gives you a pixel density of around 324 pixels per inch, and so if you actually take a closer look, you can see the pixels. I cannot see the pixels with naked eyes, and again same will happen to you as well within this video. I don't know whether you can notice the pixels, but I cannot, even when I'm looking through the camera. So all this you can do, and again this tablet will definitely give you a very good display. It is an IPS LCD display, pretty good viewing angles. The color reduction is also good enough as well. So that's all as far as the quick hands-on review of the MI Pad. I hope you like this tablet. I really like it, although the pricing is slightly higher. We are not sure about the exact pricing for which it will be sold in India, but that will be announced later and we will keep a watch on that. That's all from us. Thanks for watching this video. You can like this video if this video helped you by clicking the like button below. You can subscribe to our YouTube video channel for more videos like this by clicking the subscribe button below. Thanks for watching this video. This is Abhishek signing off. This is MI Pad, hands-on for you. Thank you.